Clearing and relief operations in the landslide-hit Ifugao, hampered by the continuing bad weather. The local disaster response office says rains during the afternoon make it difficult for responders to go in and out of the town of Banaue.
Malaking epekto po kasi yung mga nagdadala ng relief dito, siyempre pag lumalabas sila from the municipality of Banaue, tapos umuulan, medyo delikado talaga yung daan. Actually, ito, mudslides to eh.
Mm-mm.
In the morning time, binubugahan namin ng tubig with the help of our fire department. Pero ayun nga, pag umuulan, bumabalik yung putik sa kalsada at sa mga ibang kabahayan.
Baknog adds, residents have been allowed to return to their homes after they were evacuated due to flash floods and landslides. The cost of damage to agriculture in Ifugao has also risen to 48 million pesos.
Three civilians are hurt after a fire broke out, triggering a series of explosions at an arms storage building in a military camp in Cagayan de Oro City. Several families living near the ammunition complex have also been evacuated. 4th Infantry Division spokesperson Major Francisco Garello Jr. says no military personnel were hurt. The cause of the blaze is yet to be determined.
In the residual fire would have been completely contained. Just the time that the Army investigating team, our Army investigating team could come in to conduct our investigation to determine the cause of the incident. As per our record, the said house has a stock of a total of 132 howitzer 155 millimeter rounds. And we don't know yet the extent of the damage until such time na we were able to conduct a thorough investigation on this.
More cases of highly transmissible Omicron subvariants are detected in the Philippines. Health officials reported a total of 79 new infections of BA.5, BA.2.12.1, and BA.4. BA.5 makes up the highest share of cases at 60. Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergere asserts the entry of the subvariants contributes to the rise in COVID infections in the country. She notes the sublineages are more transmissible than the original Omicron variant.
The health department, meanwhile, does not see the need to mandate booster shots at this time. Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergere says this decision will need an enabling law. But she maintains the government has been doing well in encouraging Filipinos to get vaccinated. Vergere, however, admits more strategies will be needed to nudge eligible booster recipients to get their shots. Those include putting up vaccination sites in commonly visited areas.
This can be the schools, this can be the workplaces, this can be in the community. And within a community, isasama pa ho natin dyan yung mga iba't ibang lugar dun sa public, para sa publiko, sa komunidad, katulad po ng mga palengke, katulad po ng mga simbahan at iba pa ho mga public spaces in the community. So aside from implementing this settings approach, we are going to do our mapping up, especially of the primary series. At ang atin pong pinaka-focus ngayon, dahil gusto natin, mas high impact ang gagawin natin because we would want to at least have achievement of our coverage within this first 100 days of the current administration.
Shanghai conducts another round of mass testing amid persistent COVID outbreaks across China. More than half of the city's 16 districts have been told to get tested twice from Tuesday to Thursday. A similar testing campaign was also held last week in Shanghai, which is still recovering from 2 months of strict lockdown curbs. According to Reuters, more than 200 buildings in the city are currently under lockdown. The financial hub reported 59 new COVID cases Monday.